Well, it's another V day for Australia, another vaccination day. The AstraZeneca vaccine has been administered in South Australia and will be rolling out amongst other states over the course of the next few days. The vaccination program is critical, absolutely critical, to the way that Australia continues to merge from the COVID-19 pandemic and indeed the COVID-19 recession. As I said yesterday, Australia is leading the world out of the COVID-19 pandemic and out of the COVID-19 recession. We saw that with the national accounts figures that were released earlier this week, which puts Australia in the top group of nations, in fact, of advanced economies right at the top in terms of how we're coming out of the COVID-19 recession. But equally, as we've known for many months, Australia has also, from a health perspective, been very successful in suppressing the virus here in Australia, particularly when compared to other countries around the world. Australia is in a very unique position. It's a position all Australians have worked hard to achieve, to ensure that we are in the situation we are in today. National Cabinet has played a key role in all of these achievements, in all of these successes. And National Cabinet met again today and for what was once again a very constructive meeting. At all times in the National Cabinet, what we've sought to do is to chart the way forward. Of course, we come up against obstacles, we come up against issues that we have to deal with. There's been plenty of surprises too along the way, which have required responses at the time. But at all times, what we seek to try and do is ensure we're doing this on as nationally consistent basis as possible, not always achieved, but we also understand the principles that should drive how we open up. Now, the good news is that we are opening up. We are far more open than we were. We want to stay open, though. That's the key to the confidence in the economic recovery that we're seeing coming out of the COVID-19 recession. And so today it was agreed on the work that we commenced a month ago that the Directors General of all the Premier's Department and the Secretary of the Department of Prime Minister's Cabinet will continue to do the work to inform National Cabinet on how the risks are changing and the data that is needed to be provided to Premiers and myself and Chief Ministers to ensure the decisions we're making about whatever future further opening up and removing of restrictions is done in a consistent way that looks not just at the health issues that are relevant, but of course the impacts that are had more widespread on the economy. Now, the reason there is more opportunity to do that now, particularly when it comes to the economy, is because of the improvements we're seeing with the rollout of the vaccine, the improvements we're seeing in terms of the health outcomes right across the country. That gives us further opportunity to give greater certainty and greater confidence to business and Australians all around the country so they can return to as much of the normal life as they possibly can. We also received an update on the vaccination rollout today, and I'm going to ask Professor Murphy, who's joining us today, to give us his update on those programs. You would have already heard today from Minister Hunt about the issues that were raised earlier today. That program is on track. It's a significant program of a scale that we have not seen in this country before, and everybody is working together to ensure that we can deliver those vaccines all around the country. Forward distribution plans for the vaccines, the progress that we're making with aged care, the enabling regulation, which is important to support pharmacists to be able to play their role in the vaccination program, all addressed today. Of course, the Chief Medical Officer has always updated us on the health situation around the country and some of the current issues. Pacific workers, we've been able to put in place a pre-travel quarantine pilot. Now, only South Australia at this point has indicated they're keen to join in with that program, but other states are considering it. This is the situation where out of countries such as Vanuatu and Fiji, where they do actually run quarantine programs, that there will be an opportunity to quarantine post-travel to Australia as part of the seasonal worker program. That is something that's been particularly worked through with the Chief Medical Officer, and I want to thank him and also DFAT for the work they've done working with those jurisdictions. Today I can also announce that the Commonwealth is entering into an agreement with the Northern Territory Government to further expand our Howard Springs National Resilience Quarantine Facility to 2,000, up from 850. And that will be done over the next few months, and that is an important addition to the capacity of those quarantine facilities to receive those return chartered flights that Australia has been putting in place now for many, many months, and that's where people will quarantine. The other arrival caps remain as we had them before. I want to thank New South Wales in particular for taking more than 3,000 a week. Both Western Australia and Queensland are also now back over 1,000 per week, and South Australia at 530. And I'm looking forward soon to a decision from the Victorian government once they're in a position to advise us of when they'll be also in a position to take flights again. So all in all, a rather routine meeting of the National Cabinet today, considering the information before us, setting the chart, charting a way forward in terms of how we can keep Australia open and seek to do that on a far more consistent and a predictable basis, because that lies at the heart of our economic recovery as well. So.